we've really learned a lot, and surely we'll be able to answer a simple question, right? For example, if Galileo drops a ball off the Leaning Tower, how far does it fall in 2 seconds? Can we answer that? Well, we want to know distance, so I'm thinking we're going to use our relationship with x, and it's somehow proportional to t squared. But unfortunately, this is not enough information. Remember how we solved this? We used ratios. Ratios mean we need to compare two things. If I knew how far the ball fell in 1 second, or in 10 seconds, or in 7 seconds, yes, I could solve this. But I haven't even told you that. Looks like we might be in trouble. What we want is not a proportionality relationship. We want an equality. We want x equals some constant, some number that never changes, times t squared. And this constant is called the constant of proportionality. So before I just tell you what the constant is, let's learn about an amazing physical tool called dimensional analysis, where dimensional refers to the dimensions or units of a number. Because right now we know nothing about this constant. It could have units of length, it could have units of time, it could have units of time squared over length cubed, we just don't know. Let's use dimensional analysis to figure out what the units of this constant should be. We do dimensional analysis by converting everything into units of length, time, and mass, or some combination of these. Let me show you what I mean. Let's look at this equation, x equals something times time squared, and just keep track of the units. Well, x is a unit of length, it's a unit of distance. So on the left-hand side, I'll write length. And that equals some, well, unknown here, multiplied by something with units of time squared. Solving for my question mark, I find that the units of this unknown constant are length over time squared. And what has units of length over time squared? Well, length over time squared could be something like, well, meters per second squared. And that's acceleration. So this constant of proportionality that relates time and position has units of acceleration. Pretty cool. Turns out that this constant of proportionality is just 1/2 the acceleration of the object that we're talking about. For objects in free fall on Earth, this acceleration happens to be equal to 10 meters per second squared, which is why I've been using this as an example acceleration so much. In fact, this number is so important, we give it the abbreviation little g. But keep in mind, we only use this number when objects in free fall. When objects rolling, this acceleration will be, well, you tell me. Does an object rolling accelerate faster or slower?